also in charge of all basketball operations, really the leader in a lot of ways for this team.
And so it's the Thunder getting on the board first. Paul dishes to Griffin. Jordan inside. Ibaka on him. And Jordan gets it to go.
You know, it's always nice to get the easy look inside for your first points of the game.
It always seems to settle you down when you have some early success in the post. Now, that's where you like your shots to come from.
Clippers have gone just 1-4 to get this game started. Paul against Westbrook. It's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot. At this point in his career, Clark, it's safe to call Chris Paul one of the all-time great point guards.
Yeah, without question. I mean, for a long time, it was hard to argue that Chris Paul wasn't the top point guard in the league. Even now, you can make arguments for others, but Paul is always going to be in the conversation.
First one falls for.
And with Paul, it is all about his consistency. Other point guards will have better years or stretches than him, but he just puts up huge numbers year in and year out, literally like clockwork.
No good on the second free throw.
You know, it's amazing to me how little fanfare CP3 gets. I mean, he's not a flashy player, but you look at his effectiveness on the court, and he's a once-in-a-generation kind of talent. I mean, he's done it all his entire career.
And Adams with the slam.
A great assist. Nice work from Russell Westbrook.
Thunder on D. They put up a nice win against Utah last time out.
And in that game, guys, they were just about as dominant defensively on the interior as you could ever be.
And once they got a few rejections, they had opposing scorers looking for those long arms and hands. And it caused hesitation in taking shots in there.
Now here's Westbrook, following the miss by Griffin.
I'll tell you what, he earned his money on that one.
Yeah, if you're going to foul, then make sure that you don't give a chance for the and one.
When you think about guards who play without fear or any hesitation, and Russell Westbrook is the first of those guys to come to mind.
I tell you what, man, his relentless pursuit and attacking of the goal and his opponent is really something to watch.
Good at the strike this time. The second misses also.
Usually free throws are a formality for him. I didn't expect that result when he stepped up there.
Jordan kicks to Mbamute. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Jordan. Mbamute has got himself going there. His first points of the game on the deep ball.
And for Westbrook, he had some high praise. Allen Iverson said he's a huge fan of Westbrook and sees so much of himself in him, mostly due to how they play with heart. I'll tell you the other thing, Allen Iverson always felt was the most intimidating small guard in the history of the league. Russell Westbrook rapidly trying to claim that honor.
Here's Jordan following the basket by Russell Westbrook. Jordan the screen. Griffin a screen on Westbrook. Kicks it to Redick. Six on the shot clock. There's the triple. And again, Los Angeles with the triple.
Thinking back to that Iverson quote on Westbrook, they play with that same fire. The styles in which they play are different, but you can see the intensity is the same between them.
Al Paul following Durant's three-point attempt. And here is Paul. And it's blocked by Adams. They get it back. And that one's good, Griffin. And here in the first quarter, with a little over 3.5 minutes played, a moment to check in with Doris Burke. Doris?
Guys, I caught up with Doc Rivers for a minute. He knows one of the hardest parts on scoring against this defense has to do with their prolific shot blocker, Serge Ibaka. He told me he's one of those guys who can get in your head a little bit because he's so mobile. You often don't see him coming. And Kevin, you add in his great rebound and ability to hit from the bridge, and he's always an X factor for them.
Doris, thank you very much. Westbrook kicks to Roberson. Some nice passing by Oklahoma City here. It's Durant on the wing. Here's the screen. Rocket six. To end the run. There's the bucket. Good.
Guys, that's just really unstoppable. He poses a ton of matchup problems for whomever he's facing.
And the slam by Blake Griffin.
Taking it to the rack with power right there.
And oh. Hammering down with the two-handed slam.
Just piling on the lead with the dunk like that.
Now, here is Ibaka. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Here's Westbrook. Misses off the left iron.
No doubt he's struggling right now from the field. Let's see if he can get it going this quarter.
Paul kicks to Griffin. Fires it up. And a great assist by Paul as that one goes in. 8 points for Blake Griffin.
They've had assists now on their last three baskets.
And it's not just their passing, but also the body movement off the ball that's created a lot of those opportunities.
Against Westbrook. Jordan sets the pick for Paul. He's looking for Griffin, finds him, back in off the glass. Griffin's got 10.
And he came off that screen, and the D just didn't get over the top of it.
Yep, weren't there in time enough to challenge, Greg, and when that's the case, we can mark those up for him.
Here's Roberson. He dishes it to Ibaka. Here's Westbrook. And Ibaka kicks to Roberson. And again, Oklahoma City, no good.
I tell you what, they haven't wasted any time getting into the swing of things on the board.
And even this early, that's a good omen for the rest of the game.
Now here's Griffin. He's coming off a 34-point game against Detroit.
And what I enjoyed when watching that game was the way he balanced getting his shot and also incorporating his teammates.
Awesome defense. I mean, he'll hit those unless you're right in his grill.
Pass to Ibaka. Drive by Adams. Not this time. His first miss in three attempts from the field. Clippers leading by 9. Paul passes to Griffin. The tray. Again, the miss by Paul.
You know, 9 times out of 10, he's going to knock that one down. He'll spray that one on you.
Not to the surprise of anyone, really, but the Clippers last year were strong at home once again. They managed to go 30-11 at Staples
Center. And, Kevin, that makes 3 straight seasons for the Clippers of 30 or more wins at home. And really, nothing like a good old-fashioned throwdown to get a team going.
And, Greg, they do need to get going. They wouldn't mind, you know, shaving a couple more points off that lead right away.
Well, if the defense keeps giving up easy baskets like that, it won't be a lead for long. You know, the big thing for the Clippers is that they won some big games in Staples over tough opponents. I mean, also won 6 of their last 7 to secure the 3 seed in the West.
Percentage shots has been this group's specialty. On your screen now are this month's field goal percentage leaders. Andre Jordan, number 1, and of course, Kevin Durant.
Well, they've both had a fantastic run of late. They found a nice rhythm and flow, and the coaching staff has noticed and the coaches have been calling plays for these guys to take advantage of their hot shooting.
Here's what the Clippers are going with right now. Smith checked in for Griffin. Johnson comes in for Mbamute. Jamal Crawford, he's checked in for J.J. Redick. And it's Rivers in for Chris Paul.
And one issue with the Clippers at home is that it didn't feel like they were at home. Ray Griffin said home court advantage is just not there for us. And this is on the heels of a loss where the crowd was cheering for the other team louder than the Clippers at times. Yeah, and a big year for Enes Kanter last season. I mean, traded from the Jazz to the Thunder.
too many injuries to the bulk of their core.
And, you know, the big three, Durant, Westbrook, and Ibaka, all missed significant time. Only Westbrook of those three was able to finish the season.
And Cantor drops them both.
And listen, those injuries really did the Thunder in. I mean, at no time during the season did they ever really get a chance to gel and play any stretch of games with their entire roster. The shot's there for him, and he's got to take it. I don't care if he doesn't convert. That's a shot he has to continue to take.
Now here's Waiters, and the rejection by Smith. Here's Crawford. It's deflected. Augustine against Smith. Augustine with it. He's averaging a bit over 5 points a game. Passes it to Collison. The offensive rebound goes back up. It's stolen by Johnson. Crawford against Augustine. Now here's Crawford. He's guarded closely. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket's good. He'll go to the line.
You know, every franchise will have a year that is just lost to injuries. I mean, it happens. The hard part of it for the Thunder is that it happened while so many of their stars are in their prime.
And some stats here, guys. The scoring breakdown for the Clippers.
They've definitely had a hot hand from three-point range. Always nice to get off to a good start.
They've established their presence in the paint tonight. Also, a lot of their scoring to this point coming from down low.
Now here is Augustine. He's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard.
A good open look, and he splashes home the three.
Clippers leading by eight. Crawford drives in. And Cantor pulls it down.
And he rushed that one, no doubt about it. The D. Alice position, you can see the frustration on his face.
Oklahoma City's gone 1-5 from downtown in the first quarter. Points out there have been hard to come by. Crawford against Waiters.
In building this lead, they've done a terrific job finishing the defensive sequences with the backdoor. That has been key.
Yeah, you're right, Greg. Not one second chance bucket for the opposition. They're boxing out on every shot.
Here's Augustine. It's good. He makes his first shot of the game.
You know what? He wasn't going to wait around for any help on that break.
Solo Sore performance all the way. How about that for a little bit of a limber?
Shots are just flowing for him right now, having a really strong quarter.
Now the pass tomorrow. Out of bounds, the Clippers take possession.
And let's see the stat sheet here on DeAndre Jordan. This last month, he's been positively spectacular. He's averaging 11 points a game, 13 rebounds, and just over 2 blocks. And with his great size, he's a big-time force around the rim.
I like the way he goes after rebounds. He thinks every one of them is his. Same with blocking shots.
You know, I think he just wants to tinker with the game plan a little bit, and I think that's a wise timeout.
And part of it, too, Greg, was he saw some things going on out there that he didn't care for. Chance here to see where the Clippers sit in the NBA statistically right now. Second in fewest turnovers per game. Sixth in shooting percentage. And they are in the top third of the league in assists. The quality of players they have, you thought they might be better there, but not bad.
And you gotta love how well they safeguard their offensive possessions. You see the ranking, second fewest turnovers committed. Terrific ball handling and smart passing.
Pierce has checked in for Josh Smith. Johnson goes in, and Cantor pulls it down. Looking at Los Angeles,
City Thunder were able to pull him away from the college game last season, signed him to a 5-year deal in the middle of last year's playoffs.
Thunder trailing by 8. Chance to check out the standings out west. Already we're in December. Taking a look at Oklahoma City. Third best record here in the early going. And, of course, Los Angeles. A game and a half out.
And when I look at Oklahoma City, they have hit the ground running this year. The work they did in the offseason has paid huge dividends right away.
Sure it has. I mean, they came out of the preseason with a real air of confidence. There may not have been many outsiders who believed in them, but now plenty of people do.
Now here's Waiters. He had 13 points in the win against Utah. Augustine against Rivers. The three from Morrow. That's in. Augustine with the assist. Morrow's got his second basket of the night. Los Angeles leading by 5. We've got 1:23 left here in the opening quarter. Now the dish to Crawford. Outside, Pierce. 6 on the shot clock. Softly drops in the floater. Pierce has got his first bucket of the night.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Yeah, I think they've got to ramp up the aggressiveness, Greg. I mean, if they don't, things are just going to get worse from here.
Pass to Augustine. Waiters with the ball. And Crawford picks him up defensively. That's good.
Well, there's not a whole lot you can do about that move. That's just good offense. They were all over him, and he still managed to drain.
Rivers dishes to Jordan. It's Pierce on the wing. Jordan the screen. The shot by Pierce will not go.
It's not winning basketball when you're attempting shots like that.
Yeah, come on now. You got to remember it's a team game. He's got 4 teammates out there with him. I don't think he needs to try to do it all by himself like that.
And that one's good.
It seems that every pass they make is leading to a score here. I mean, that's just exquisite ball movement.
And that's because the ball is looking for the best shot, and it's really paid off for them during the run.
Here's Crawford. 14 points from him the last game against Detroit. And play stops. This one, what looks to be an illegal screen.
Yeah, good call there. I mean, he's clearly moving when he set the screen.
And he lowered the shoulder, too. I mean, they were going to get him there one way or the other. I mean, that was an easy call.
From deep 3-point range, he got it up that time, but it wouldn't fall for him. Good close contest so far as we finish the first quarter. Clippers ahead. They lead by 3. We'll be back shortly live from Staples Center in downtown Los Angeles. DeAndre Jordan, not a focal point offensively for this team, but as a defender, he understands he can make a big difference.
I'm not really a big scorer for our team, but that's not my job. My job is to defend and rebound for our team, and you know, I've accepted my role, and I feel like I'm, you know, excelling in my role.
Jordan, a man who knows what his job is, and he likes his job, Clark, and does it very, very well. He is excelling.
Yeah, he is. He may not be the NBA's Defensive Player of the Year, but he is certainly the Clippers' Defensive Player of the Year. Jordan's become thing of it is he's still learning and growing. He's going to continue to get better, which is scary.
Either team able to build much of a lead up to this point as we start the second quarter. Guys, what's your take on the Clippers so far?
You can tell the point of emphasis has been to get to the offensive glass.
Yep, and they've set the tone here early with the hustle they've come out with.
They've got J.J. Redick. Griffin is out there with Pierce. Then it's Mbamute, and it's Rivers in at the one spot. They're the group out there for the Clippers starting the second quarter. Thunder trailing by three. And an interesting byproduct of Blake Griffin extending his shooting range and his perimeter defense, Clark, his rebounding numbers have gone way down.
Well, it's hard to have it both ways, Kevin. I mean, the team needs him to keep working on his perimeter game, and if he's out on the perimeter, it makes it tougher for him to get rebounds.
Shot clock at three, and that one's good. Durant. Durant's got the second quarter going with the first basket of the period for the Thunder. Rivers kicks to Redick. There's a screen. Griffin passes to Rivers. Picked by Griffin. And a wide open shot from Redick. Three-pointers off the mark.
And on the topic of Griffin's rebounding, there's another force that helps submarine his numbers. DeAndre Jordan. Over the past few seasons, as Jordan's boards went up, Griffin's have gone down. Now, you think with the two elite rebounders that the team would finish better than 20th in rebounding last year, but that's another story.
Now, here's Westbrook. He had 25 points in the win against Utah.
Yeah, but he was also a force on the defensive side. Two block shots and also altered a ton of shots.
And back to Griffin for a minute. I think he will soon find a balance between his emerging perimeter game and his rebounding. 7.5 boards a game, far too few for him last year. He's likely to return the double-digit rebounding averages, I think, sometime soon.
Two shots.
Ties it up, and this next one could give them the lead. Well, it was a season last year of heartbreak and change for the Thunder, narrowly missing the playoffs as the Pelicans beat them out for that eighth position.
Yeah, and they were teetering back and forth on that eighth spot for most of the year. Ultimately, they just couldn't hold on to that final playoff spot.
Josh Smith, he's checked in for the Clippers. Paul comes in for Austin Rivers.
Guys, for the Thunder, that playoff miss was the first time they did make the postseason since their first year in Oklahoma. Fans have really been spoiled with how successful the Thunder have been of late.
And the Thunder with the possession here. Josh Smith missing from long range. And Roberson kicks to Westbrook. And the go-ahead bucket, no good. For Los Angeles, they've gone 0-3 and are still looking for that first bucket here in the second quarter. The feed to Redick. Launches it. And a great assist by Paul as that one goes in. Paul's got four assists in the game.
And the Western playoffs just, it seemed a bit amiss without having the Thunder involved. Westbrook, I tell you what, he did everything he could to try and carry that injured group into the postseason last year, but it just wasn't to be. He is just really almost playing for the other team. The shooting has just been poor.
Here's Roberson now in the scoring column with that deuce. 1-for-2 this game.
And I like how he puts himself in position there to finish on the break.
Yeah, you know, that's what we call seeing and feeling the game. Excellent read of how that play was going to develop and where the ball was going. That's stuff that you oftentimes can't teach, Greg.
Redick for three, and Kanter pulls it down. Kanter's got six rebounds now in the game.
He's tried to get it going, but the shots simply have not been there. Nothing seems to be falling.
For Oklahoma City, they have shot 3 of 6 at the foul line. That free throw, no good.
And the Clippers not known for being an outside shooting team, but they take a large amount of deep mid-range twos as well as their fair share of three.
DeAndre Jordan's checked in for the Clippers. And Oklahoma City also making a switch. Steven Adams, he's checked in for Kanter. think of Lob City and it's all dunks, but the reality is, Clark, as Greg was just talking about, that just isn't the case.
It really isn't. I mean, they also led the league in pull-up shots attempted by a wide margin, about 24 pull-up Jays a game.
And not the prototype power forward, but he has tremendous athletic ability.
It's taken away by Smith. He kicks it to Paul. Closing in on 4 minutes played here in the second quarter. Back to Smith. Nice passing here by Los Angeles. Stolen by Durant. And the dunk to finish it off. A beauty.
And guys, that's a big swing right there. I mean, taking the steal and then turning it into two easy points on the dunk.
No telling how important that sequence could turn out to be.
And guys, in a game this snug, moments like that are the ones we usually look back on at the end as a difference maker.
Here's Redick, following the score by Oklahoma City. We're on the shot clock. A post shot. The Thunder pull it in.
He's been wayward and just off on about everything he's put up in this period.
Durant kicks to Ibaka. And they set the pick. Takes the three. That doesn't go either for Durant.
You know what, though? Sometimes you can be too open. The pick it may have surprised him, and that's why he missed.
Redick, a good look. And a great assist by Paul as that one goes in. Paul's got 5 assists tonight. Oklahoma City trailing. Westbrook dishes to Robertson. And Andre Robertson is going to pick up the foul. That's his first foul.
And really just a great play to sacrifice his body and take the charge.
Heads up action there. Reading the play and then beating him to the spot. Well done.
Paul. He's coming off a 13-point game against the Pistons in Detroit. Smith outside. Fires the three. Dishes it to Redick. Smith sets the pick for Redick. Another shot. That one wide left.
And that was a difficult shot from mid-range simply because the defense was engaged.
Yeah, and I think the quickness of the closeout really threw him off.
Now, here is Ibaka. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Durant, the pass to Westbrook. A three. That's good.
Don't underestimate him. He can knock that down.
The Clippers trail. Over to the left wing. And Bob Amute. And right away, they match it with a three-pointer of their own.
Tit for tat right there, huh, guys?
Didn't take them long at all, fellas, to get those 3 points back.
Usually, you talk about how tough a player is, and you're always talking about big guys. But Chris Paul is as tough as they come playing that little point guard position.
Yeah, he's a power pack when you look at him. I mean, he's played through a lot of injuries and still has a big-time impact on the game. Most recently in the playoffs, he played through injury to beat the Spurs.
He's putting up 13 points a game, over 2.5 blocks, and 6 rebounds. And he's really been pulling his weight. He's had a hand in some big plays here recently.
Yeah, in every way, I think he's doing a much better job, and the numbers certainly support that.
Catching up on the changes for the Clippers. Johnson, he's checked in for Mbamute. And it's Crawford in for J.J. Redick. And Oklahoma City with a change here, too. Waiters is checked in. It's stolen by Smith. Here's Paul. It's deflected. Durant against Paul. Ibaka. Pelicans currently providing 16.5 points a game. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
And by the way, there's traded last season to the Thunder. They wanted him as a shooting and scoring threat off the bench. Didn't want him to try and fill the void that Harden played when he was a member of the team.
And look at how the hustle game has been going for the Thunder.
Boy, you have to admire their intensity in the paint defensively.
Right, gentlemen,
really contesting and even blocking shots. Definitely a factor early.
And the other thing that's been equally as effective is the fact that they've gotten out on the fast break. A lot of points coming in transition.
And the first one drops. You know, Greg, for waiters, it would be unfair for the Thunder to ask that of anybody. You know, that's tough to do. Clark, hard to make up what Harden had accomplished.
Yeah, and the Thunder even asked waiters not to wear number 13 to avoid any comparisons,
right,
which I think was a smart move. But they still would like to have him provide some punch in terms of points off the bench.
And he makes the first, but misses the second. Yes, fans, Clark, and the one team they view as floppers is the Clippers. I don't like that word, but it just kind of came out. Whether that is fair or not is up for debate, but it is certainly, I think, the perception.
And I think there's some truth to that perception. I mean, multiple players have received fines for flopping on their roster. I mean, you can't run away from that, and the fans remember it, too.
Oh, they do, yes, sir.
How about the way he's able to angle his body to shield the big fella off and still get the finish?
You've got to be clever with your sleight of hand when you get inside and try to finish against the bigger guys. He made it look easy that time.
Now, here's Collison after Wesley Johnson's miss. Raiders against Johnson. Out left of the wing. 5-1. They get the rebound. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there.
And really the defense fouling there to prevent the layup, but that's exactly what you need to do.
It is. I mean, no reason to back off and give him the layup. Much better off making him go to the line.
Okay, gentlemen, two shots. Two shots.
First one at the line is good.
And for the Clippers and flopping, part of it might just be reputation. Whenever anyone hits the deck on their team, fans might be quick to kind of condemn that as a flop.
Los Angeles making a switch here. Rivers checked in. Collison hits them both.
You know, the Clippers were the darlings of the NBA as they improved and made strides, but I think the flopping has kind of diminished that now, that love affair. Being labeled a group of floppers can certainly stifle your popularity.
Now, when you think of the great playmakers in league history, John Stockton per game averaged double-digit dimes. Think of this, for his career, 15,806 career assists, a record you knew right off would stand for a very long time.
And guys, you know, you look up point guard in the dictionary, and there's a nice little picture of John Stockton there. I mean, he is an unreal distributor. Controlled the game like no one ever has before or since. It's no coincidence that Utah never missed the playoffs in any of the 19 seasons that John Stockton was at the helm.
All right, now, gentlemen, two shots. Move shot.
Good, Smith. The guy, Josh Smith, an interesting case. Clark, he shot about two triples a game last year, yet for the last three seasons, his free throw percentage has been under, surprisingly, 55%.
Yeah, and that's terribly troubling. I mean, his three-point percentage improved in Houston, but the free throws, really, he can do much better than that. You look at his stroke, I think it's just a matter of concentration with Josh.
And with Smith and his shooting, a lot of it is mental. I mean, he has a terrific stroke from anywhere. The free throws are all in his head because he can make threes. He's just got to be a little more focused.
Now here is Augustine. Down low. Morrow, that's a two-pointer. No luck. And it's the Clippers taking it the other way. Next up in the docket, the Bucks following this one. That'll
shots for the Rockets last year, but you never know quite what you're going to get with him taking perimeter shots.
Andre Jordan has been extremely productive over 7 years. That makes it even more unbelievable that there was
one
some
shot.
Question, Clark,
mind the lane.
As to his commitment to basketball
one
coming
shot.
Into the league.
Yeah, you know, on talent and athleticism alone, he would have been a top 10 pick for sure, but he slipped to the second round, and he's made good on it, though.
Jordan, no good on the free throw.
And watching DeAndre Jordan, he's really refined his game over the years without losing the athleticism. He's that rubbery, long-limbed athlete that transcends age. And so far, I've seen zero drop-off in his leaping ability and quickness. But no question, he's improved his skills and IQ.
Now here's Crawford. 8 points for him. Let's a floater go. Augustine kicks to Collison. Feeds it to Waiters. Out to the right wing. Wide open. Augustine, no luck.
And talking about DeAndre Jordan, he is displaying an energy level that many scouts wondered if he had. Let's face it, he underachieved a bit in his 1 year in college. He knows that. But when it's come time to do it at the highest level, DeAndre has risen to the occasion.
The league leaders in rebounding, the real stats, the real scores from the real NBA. Andre Jordan is second.
And you can't win games without rebounding the basketball. That's what has made him such an important part of what they do.
Griffin's checked in for DeAndre Jordan. And Oklahoma City with a change here, too. Cantor's checked in. There's the pick. It's tipped. Griffin with the steal. And now the Clippers on the break. Takes the assist and lays it in. Picked out the pass nicely. Now it's a 3-point Clipper lead. Oklahoma City's gotten cold from deep in the second quarter. Just 2-6 from long range. Rivers against Augustine. To the paint. Here's Collison. And he gets it to go.
Forcing that ball into the paint. Smash mouth basketball.
And Clark, it's a strategy that has served them well during the course of this first half.
And watching Nick Collison, he makes all the hustle plays, all the little plays, the things that really will not show up in a score sheet, stat sheet. For over a decade, he's had that role and embraced it.
And Kevin, the other thing he does as a veteran is a coach knows what he's going to get. He doesn't make the mistakes that some players make. And while he's not going to be a great scorer in the post or hot flying rim protector, this game really is built on intelligence and toughness. And so positioning for charges, making open mid-range jump shots, all the unsung things that help a team win game.
Griffin with the steal. Now the Clippers moving it up. Clippers has got the ball. The shot by Pierce will not go. And they're trailing by three. Morrow kicks to Collison. Three-pointer, Augustine.
some huge numbers offensively.
Yeah, you know, you just plug him in. He's a flat-out scoring machine. When you plug him up, let him go.
Now here's Johnson. He's had some playing time, but no score yet for him. And the foul on Paul Pierce. That's foul number two for him. Thunder trailing by five. And here's Augustine. There's a screen by Cantor. Collison with a screen on Rivers. And Cantor wide open. He shoots. And it's good off the back rim and in.
Perfect screen there. Set him up with a terrific look.
Yeah, I like the fact that the setup was good. The screen was solid. But you also have to look at the fact that the defender didn't do his job as well as he could have.
Now here's Pierce. He's got five. Johnson attacking. A stupendous finish in traffic. And the Clippers lead by five. Rivers again to Augustine. He feeds it to Cantor. Baseline jumper. No good.
That is the perfect technique to rebound. I mean, he shields his man, kept him behind, and then he's off to the races.
In a pretty tightly contested game here as we end the first half. Clippers ahead as they wrap up the second quarter on a 14-5 run. And a chance now to send you over to Doris Burke, standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Josh, you guys seemed intent on getting this win tonight. How important a game was this to this team?
Almost definitely. I mean, this game is as important as the next. We really need this win. I'm pretty sure they need it too. So, you know, you expect a good show out of all of us.
Two hungry teams, no doubt about it, Josh. Thanks for the time.
Thank you, Doris, for that interview. And we'll see you back here after the break for the third quarter of basketball.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Welcome back, folks. Ernie Johnson here along with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. We're going to break down the first half action for you. Some incredible work in this one by Blake Griffin. He had 12 points, 5 rebounds, and 2 steals. And taking a look at the Clippers, Kenny, what did you see out there?
Efficiency, efficiency, efficiency. The 3 E's, Shaq. That's all I got to say. They've avoided turning the basketball over, and that's a recipe for success. Now, here's how they do it. By sacrificing the highlight reel plays, you get good looks, and those home run plays will still come.
And now, Shaq, let's get your opinion on Oklahoma City.
Their transition game was really strong. It really fueled them, gave them a big injection of energy into the offense. If they can maintain that fast style in the second half, they got a great chance to take control of this game.
So that does it for us. Hope you enjoyed our halftime show. Now, we take you back to Kevin Harlan for the second half call.
We have a close ball game on our hands as we get set for the second half of basketball.
Blake Griffin doing all sorts of things. 12 points, and he's come away with 2 steals as well. Blown up some plays out there.
And it also shows you the importance of intelligence as a defender, because he has been a nightmare on the ball.
free slot.
That is so tough to defend. He'll cross you over in a nanosecond. That move is next to unstoppable.
One of the most dominant players in 2014 was Kevin Durant, of course, winning the league MVP. Then last year, cut short. We know that he's now on a mission to get back to that level. And Greg, it's hard.
Yeah, you know, it all came down to health for Kevin Durant. And at this point in his career, I mean, he's got the maturity. He's developed the skill set. He's just got to stay on the court. And really, when you talk about the game of basketball, the rest will take care of itself.
Those defenders look like they're out of gas. I mean, they're getting pushed around on the low block.
Yeah, but they better rally soon because they've given up three straight buckets in the paint.
It's Westbrook with the drive. And you can count it. He'll go to the line with a chance to make it three.
You know, talking about Durant as he looks to recapture the league MVP, he can take a cue from last year's MVP, Stephen Curry. Curry battled through numerous ankle injuries over the years earlier on, only to come out on the other side with his best season ever in 2K15.
And getting back to Durant, sometimes adversity brings out the best in you. Adversity challenges you to rise above. And Kevin was already at the highest rung on the ladder. I think his opponent should be very afraid of what they're about to witness this season.
Now here's Paul, and Griffin shoves it in.
You can see the eye contact there. Gave a little nod and then burst to the rim for the alley-oop slam.
No doubt, Clark. A pair of teammates with a terrific feel for each other out on the floor. into the second half. Pocket two. Here's Griffin. The offensive rebound. And Abamute kicks to Griffin. Paul, left side. Jordan sets the pick for Paul. Tries again. Reddick with the bucket. Reddick's got 12 in the game.
What a sweet assist by CP3.
Last year, the Thunder were in a playoff battle all season, Clark. Their road record of 16-24, a big part of why they didn't sneak into the playoffs.
Well, when you're dealing with the kind of injuries the Thunder had last year, it's impossible to be your best, and grinding out road wins is that much tougher.
And Bahamute dishes to Jordan. Passes it to Paul. Feed now to Mbamute. Good, and Paul gets the assist. Mbamute has got his third bucket of the night.
And really, with the Thunder and their road problems last season, both Phoenix and New Orleans had better road records than they did. And had the Thunder been tougher on the road, no doubt they would have made it in.
The pass to Jordan, and Reddick kicks to Griffin. Shoots. That doesn't go either for Griffin. Trailing by six. Roberson the pass to Westbrook. And there's a nice one-handed slam.
And Kevin, who says a point guard should look to pass first? I mean, not when you can finish like this, though.
Well, Clark, he wasn't going to give that opportunity up to a teammate.
Well, you know, Kevin, that's one he'll always take himself. And he should. I mean, you can't pass up that kind of opportunity or fun. You know, the Thunder had road trouble right out of the gate last season, guys. Only had one road win in their first nine road games. They also had four different instances of four or more game road losing streaks last season.
Now, here's Adams. He's got six. Westbrook dishes to Roberson. Griffin grabs the board. Los Angeles leading by six. Ball movement by the Clippers. Here's Jordan, and it's blocked by Adams. Westbrook with it. He's got 12. It's Durant on the wing. Ibaka outside. Here's Roberson. Gets it to go from beyond the arc. Roberson's got his second basket of the night.
He can be a forgotten man in their offense sometimes, but the D still has to keep an eye on him.
Paul kicks to Griffin, and he connects on the jumper. The screen did the trick, and the Clippers lead by five.
He's played an important role in their offense today, guys. Without him, they may not be in the lead.
Surreal. Averaging about 27 points a game, 8 rebounds, and 5 assists. And what sets him apart is his rebounding. And as you can see, he's been in peak form.
This last stretch, unbelievable force going to the glass. And it's been reflected on the stat sheet.
Josh Smith, he's checked in for Mbamute. Dennis Kanter's checked in for the Thunder. Off the inbound, and the bucket counts. And he's on his way to the free throw line. Try to make it a three-point play.
And when you look at Serge Ibaka, it's amazing how methodically he's worked on his shooting. I mean, it seems like every year his range extends another couple of feet. He now has one of the best mid-range jumpers in the game, and that has obviously opened up the offense.
Johnson. He's checked in for DeAndre Jordan. Crawford comes in for J.J. Redick. And it's Rivers in for Paul.
And Griffin sends it back.
Here's Crawford. Los Angeles with another miss. Under trailing by three. The dish to Durant. And out of bounds as Los Angeles gains possession. Anthony Morrow's checked in for the Thunder. Augustine comes in for Russell Westbrook. Clippers leading by three. Pass to Griffin. Screen by Smith. Rivers against Augustine. Smith sets the pick for Rivers. He kicks it to Smith. And that'll be Oklahoma City's ball as it goes out of bounds. Thunder trailing by three. Here's Augustine. There's a screen by Cantor. Augustine, that's good. Augustine's got six.
Hard to get that one off with the size difference there. That makes it a tough individual matchup for him, especially down low.
Well, took on the big guys going in there and challenging them like he did. And boy, that was a nice job. A one-hand tomahawk for you, folks.
That got their entire bench right up and out of their chair.
And Kevin, how about the reaction from his teammates, not just on the bench, but the guys even in the game.
Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
It's been a good game for Mr. Crawford. He has 12 points, and from long range, he's hit 1 3-pointer.
And when it's all said and done, I got a sneaky suspicion he's going to have a few more.
Now let's take a moment to get your guys' take on the scoring so far for Los Angeles.
Boy, their passing has been picturesque, a thing of beauty in both halves. More than a few of their baskets have come off assists.
Couple that with just how well they've shot it from beyond, and they've made this thing look easy.
And so Jamal Crawford nails both of them.
Boy, for Jamal Crawford, guys, it's been a really good career. Not many guys can maintain his level of quickness after 15 years in the league. I mean, but last season, he finally started to show a little wear and tear.
And back to Crawford, last season, he was down in field goal and three-point percentage. Plus, he battled with a calf injury that ultimately kept him out of 17, 18 games late in the year.
Yeah, Kevin, but his deep range spread the floor when he was out there. He still has that presence about him that you have to honor him. And he also hits some very timely shots, a dangerous assassin who always needs to be accounted for.
Ibaka hits both of them.
The story in the first half was their low free throw percentage. They've corrected that here in the second half, and hopefully they can build on it as this game continues to progress.
Ibaka comes with the double team. Griffin dishes to Johnson. Smith on the wing. Back to Johnson. Some nice ball movement by the Clippers. And the clock. Here's Rivers. Here's Smith. And it goes as the official calls the foul. Count it. He'll shoot one more at the free throw line.
He was the first one to react to that miss. Excellent anticipation on his part. A hustle play on the putback by him.
Nick Collison's checked in for Serge Ibaka. The Clippers have shot 60% from the line, 6 of 10.
And guys, Josh Smith, an interesting blend of talent. A good defender, great finisher around the rim. Also an underrated passer at times for a big man.
Cantor, and good. Coming in on the assist by DJ Augustine.
And good passing, setting up a lot of these buckets right now, Kevin. That's been the key.
Time dropping delights is what I call it.
That was a nice pass. I will give you that one.
Yeah, he's on. overall pick back in the 2011 draft. Everyone thought he would have the jump shot to become a prolific scorer and park the link to defend at a high level.
Yeah, you know, in his rookie year, he averaged 9 points a game. Last year, his fifth, he averaged 10. I think it's to the point where he is what he is.
Pierce has checked in for the Clippers. Good on both.
You know, getting back to Wesley Johnson, you kind of want to kidnap him and just chain him to a set of weights. I mean, he has all the natural ability in the world to be a difference maker, but he just lacks the strength to do anything with it. I mean, a voracious competitor in college, he's been relegated to marginal production at the pro level, and I really feel like a lot of it is because he physically struggles at times at this level.
Clippers leading by six. Crawford outside. Johnson, that's for two. Los Angeles with another miss.
Very dangerous to leave a guy like that open. Lucky break there for the D.
And Waiters kicks to Augustine. And Morrow has it in the corner. From outside, off the mark.
You know, on the topic of Wesley Johnson, I remember him in college. I remember the guy who took over games and even showed a certain toughness when he did it. He hasn't gotten to that point here in the pros, so he may soon be entering a crossroads in his career.
And for all of the improvements he's made to his game, one wonders why Blake Griffin isn't a better shot blocker. I mean, he clearly has the motor and the athleticism, but for some reason over his first five seasons, he's averaged only a half a block per game.
And regarding Griffin's low block shot number, for some guys, they simply lack a certain field card for blocking shots.
Yeah, you know, there's something about the aptitude for shot blocking that sometimes is understated. Just because you're a high flyer in the front court doesn't mean you're going to block a lot of shots.
Crawford with the ball. And it's Waiters picking him up. He's feeling it. That shot by Griffin, no good. Thunder trailing by nine. Now Augustine, he has six. To the left side wing. Here's Cantor. Excellent D there from Pierce.
If they could end every possession with that shot, they'd be happy. Nine times out of ten, that's an easy layup for them.
How about that one? Able to maintain control and finish the play.
Yeah, we call that playing through the whistle. You know, he didn't give up on it when he heard the whistle. He kept his focus, his concentration, and he found a way to get the shot up and down.
And Oklahoma City making a change here. Durant's checked in. You know, you work hard all season, Greg, to try and get into the playoffs, then get a favorable first-round matchup. How about the Clippers last year? Followed those steps. They're rewarded with the first-round matchup against the defending champions of the league, the San Antonio Spurs.
And not only were the Spurs the defending champions, but they came in playing terrific basketball down the stretch, which is kind of what they are noted for. And the Clippers, though, did well, even though that was the case.
Shooting two. Shooting two.
That's good from Cantor. And that one goes in. Two from the line that time.
This is what they need to do in the second half to come out with the win. It's not the only thing, but when you convert free throws at the other end, you put a lot of pressure on the opponent to play solid defense against you.
Now here's Johnson, currently averaging almost 6 points a game. Dishes it to Pierce. Los Angeles with another miss. step aside for just a second, but join us right back here for the start of the fourth quarter next. Welcome back as we get set to start the fourth. Los Angeles leading by 10. All fueled up and ready to go. As we set the lineup for courtesy of Petering for the fourth quarter. And the Clippers, looking at who they've got, Chris Paul and J.J. Redick are the guards. Luke Mbamute out there with Pierce. And it's Jordan in at the center position. Got that one up quick. And it's 13 points for Enes Kanter.
Textbook. Nice pass. Great catch. Even better finish.
Paul passes to Jordan. To the middle. Clippers moving the ball around. Jordan the screen. The shot's good from Paul.
Consistency. Five buckets in a row from the paint.
And on the flip side, Greg, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior. They've got to offer more resistance here.
Now here's Durant. Paul with the steal. And now Redick pushing it up. No one back to stop him. It's Westbrook with the drive. And it's Durant missing. Clippers leading by 12. Here's Paul. Feeds it to Mbamute. Six on the shot clock. Thunder with the rebound. Kanter's got 11 rebounds in the game. Durant kicks to Roberson. Westbrook wide open. He fires. Good for basket number six from him in the contest. He's shooting 6 for 12.
And you can just see he's a different player since coming back from halftime.
They set the screen. Pierce dishes to Paul. And here's the whistle. Fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line. They get Russell Westbrook.
And for long stretches of the season, the Thunder, they had a short bench early on due to the injury and just having a short rotation. They did change things up, though, as they went through that regular season.
For the Thunder, Greg, you're talking about, they did have to go to their bench more and more. And Clark, as the season wore on, their bench players were playing a lot of minutes.
Yeah, actually, they ended up in the top 10 in bench minutes played. The trades they made at the deadline helped bring depth to the team, and they took advantage of it.
Smith checked in for the Clippers. And Oklahoma City also making a switch. Adams, he's checked in for Kanter. And so Paul nails both of them.
They got to keep fighting their way to the line, guys. This half has been nothing but success for them there.
Yeah, taking full advantage from the charity stripe. They've yet to miss here in the second.
Durant, and it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
And, guys, it's easy to forget sometimes just how young Kevin Durant still is. I mean, last season, he became the second youngest player to get to 15,000 points.
Now, gentlemen, two shots. Two shots.
That's good from Durant. For Durant getting to 15,000 points, the only player, Clark, to do it quicker was LeBron James.
Yeah, and it's even more impressive when you realize that Durant did spend 1 year in college, Kevin. You take a year off his age, and he and LeBron got to that point plateau in virtually the same amount of time.
And both free throws good for Durant.
What a performance from Durant here. 15 points and 4 assists.
Offensively, defensively, man, he has done it all.
All hustle, nonstop effort. He just doesn't quit. Great resilience and relentlessness in his play. Well, in the rebounding game, at least, it's been a strong
points in the quarter.
First three of the half, second of the game. Can he heat up?
D-L-A!
Quickly over to Doris Burke for an update.
Guys, over that last break, I listened to Doc Rivers address his team. He wants to make sure they stay assertive and aggressive on the offensive end, saying, I don't want to sit on this lead. Let's build on it and not give them a chance of coming back. Guys?
And the Clippers making a switch here. Griffin's checked in. And that'll be Oklahoma City's ball as it goes out of bounds.
And that's just carelessness there. I mean, you have got to have your head in the game.
And Bahamute against Westbrook. Robertson dishes to Westbrook. Adams, the pass to Durant. He feeds it to Westbrook. Releases. No good off the back of the rim.
That's a huge part of what they want to do defensively. Limit his easy chances inside.
Jordan the screen. And he's going up for the alley-oop. Takes the alley-oop pass and dunks it down.
And the lead just grows on that ridiculous offensive sequence.
Looks like that dunk alone would have been spectacular. Never mind it coming at the end of an alley-oop.
Yeah, that just added more to it.
And you know, guys, right now they're starting to flatline, just hanging on here for dear life.
Los Angeles leading by six. Paul kicks to Jordan. Amute against Durant, Jordan the screen, and out of bounds as the Thunder gain possession.
That is just a careless turnover. You've got to be smarter in those exchanges.
And Amute with the steal.
Despite his ineffectiveness, the team has found other scoring options, which you have to have when one of your main guys is struggling.
Here's Roberson, and out of bounds as Los Angeles gains possession.
That is just a careless turnover. You've got to be smarter in those exchanges.
LA's gone 2-for-2 from three-point land to start the fourth quarter. Paul dishes to Redick. Inside, here's Griffin. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one, drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there.
No question, he got bumped on that shot.
Yeah, the officials didn't need to talk that one over. It was obvious. Well, we all know how loud NBA arenas can get. I mean, last season there were some accusations thrown around that it wasn't all organic. I mean, some players felt as if some of the NBA crowd noise was artificial.
A free throw drops for Griffin. Some heavy accusations about artificial noise being pumped in last year. We've seen the issue in the NFL, talked about now in the NBA. Seeing it in other sports, there's a case that maybe the NBA's got to deal with this.
Oh, there's no doubt about it. I know some stadiums, it might feel like there is extra noise being pumped in. And listen, there are a lot of fan bases that we have are just flat out loud. I mean, it can be electric. But having said that, I don't think we want to have the artificial noise being pumped in. I think it does. does the game a disservice.
Now, here's Westbrook. Ibaka outside. That's good, and so Westbrook comes up with the assist. Westbrook's got his fourth assist with that last one here tonight. Los Angeles leading by nine. It's stolen by Ibaka. Outside Durant. Screen by Ibaka. Fires the three. And again, Oklahoma City with the triple.
You know, the defense has got to do a much better job of fighting over those screens.
And, Greg, especially when the ball is in his hand. I mean, come on now. You know, he doesn't miss too many open looks like that.
Now here's Paul. Takes the 13-footer. But they get it there. Here is Mbamute, and right through it goes. Under trailing by eight. And here's Westbrook. He dishes it to Adams. That is good. That gives him the double-double. 10 points and 13 rebounds. Clippers have gone 6 of 11 since the start of the fourth quarter. Paul kicks to Griffin. Jordan with a screen on a buck. They double-team Griffin. Down low. And DeAndre Jordan pulls it down.
Oh, just a lovely dish by Griffin.
The Thunder shooting well. 50% from the floor. And Mbamute against Westbrook. Griffin with the rebound. Griffin's got his seventh rebound of the game with that last one. Here's Jordan, and down it goes. Dunk threw off a wonderful assist.
Boy, he threw out some punishment with that two-hand throwdown.
And Clark, now's the time to do it. Continue to attack that rim.
Overs on the pass to Westbrook. Hits to Adams. Durant against Paul. Durant dishes to Ibaka. The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
And he can time his passes so perfectly. Wow, what an assist.
And, guys, Serge Ibaka's production was just a little off last season. We're not talking, you know, big number changes. We're talking small dips in a number of categories.
Well, one category where he did really fall off, though, Kevin, was field goal percentage. A career 53% shooter, he dropped down to 47.
Now here's Paul. And Griffin shoves it in.
He has really shot the ball extremely well, as you'd expect. Like we say, he's been making sweet string music all day long.
And Mbamute against Westbrook. Pass to Adams. Shot is off. Nice D from Griffin. Clippers leading by nine. And Redick kicks to Jordan. Wasted no time on that shot, but it's off the mark. Oklahoma City's gone 2-3 in the fourth quarter from long range. Good shooting so far. And the foul called on Russell Westbrook. That's his third foul of the game. Cantor checked in for Oklahoma City. Los Angeles now. And the slam by Blake Griffin.
Yeah, you're right. I don't know what he did in the locker room, but he needs to do a little bit more of it because he's on fire.
Westbrook passes to Roberson. And there's the feed to Ibaka. They set the screen. Cantor with a screen on Mbamute. Clock at four. And it's a bounds. Oklahoma City able to retain possession. three that time from Jordan.
And you can see the defender's afraid to kind of get in his way a lot of times when he's on his way to the basket. But on that one, they were there.
Now, here's Mbau Mucha. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two. Good on that.
He's done a much better job of getting to the line here, aggressively taking it inside and not shying away from contact. I thought he was settling a bit in the first.
And he sinks the second. Trailing by 12. Outside Durant. There's a good screen. Kemba Emeje with the steal. And here we go. Fast break. Paul's got it. That's good. Redick's got 5 points in the quarter.
And with their hot shooting here in the second half, their field goal percentage over 50% now for the game.
Yeah, it's not a surprise then to see them out in front. The way they've been efficient offensively in this half and actually throughout the entire game.
Closer to finishing this one off.
If they haven't already done it. I mean, hey, it's been a tremendous all-around performance from this group. I don't think there's any question about that.
Here's Roberson. The Clippers getting the bucket. The pass to Ibaka. Shot to end this cold run. Shot is off. And the Clippers will go the other way with it.
And this is going to end in a lopsided victory. I love the tenacity and aggressiveness as well as the ability to close. You really got to give it up here for the Clippers.
But their inside game was what secured them the win tonight.
Yeah, Kevin, they had their way in the paint, and those are all high percentage shots.
And for the year now, they'll be tallying their 16th win.
A fantastic show. And what an amazing all-around game it was for Griffin. There wasn't much they could do to slow him down as he was converting every good chance he got.
A platoon swap here for the Clippers. ...50 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Morrow kicks to Augustine. To the paint, here's Collison, and good! Coming in on the assist by DJ Augustine.
I love the low post attack on that one.
Rivers with it. Here's the screen. And Waiters over to help. Crawford dishes to Smith. Rivers kicks to Johnson. Off target with his three. Now Augustine. And it's Rivers with the rebound.
Good pick, but he just couldn't make it count.
Yeah, nice job of setting the screen by his teammate there. I'm sure he appreciated it.
So the Clippers winning this one easily. They poured it on tonight, Clark. A dominant showing in front of a crowd that love every minute of it.
I don't think they have anything but positives to take away from this win. Offensively, defensively, every aspect of the game, it all went right for them.
And now let's catch up with Doris Burke, who's standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Chris, how does a win like this help propel the team at this point in the schedule?
Hopefully it gives us a little momentum. We got a tough stretch coming up. We got our back-to-back next week, so hopefully it just gives us a little momentum.
That was a pretty good start, Chris. Thank you. Kevin, back to you.
Doris, thank you as always. And that about wraps it up for Clark Kellogg. Greg Anthony and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for tuning in. Now we'll go to the studio with the award-winning Ernie Johnson.
The 2K Sports post-game show.
Ernie Johnson here again with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny Smith. Without further ado, let's present to you our Jordan player of the game, Blake Griffin. He came out of the locker room at halftime and was immediately on fire. That third quarter was his, and he did not hesitate to exert his will.
Is there anyone in the NBA who's more straight up scary than Blake Griffin? I don't think so. Big, strong, powerful, with the skills to match that athleticism. If you're a defender in the post and you see Blake Griffin coming down the lane, the only thing you think is, uh-oh, the man is just a beast.
Well, his ability to get into the paint, get to the rim was deadly. For a guy who's mainly a perimeter shooter, it was remarkable how many of his points came right at the bucket.
And that'll do it for tonight. For Kenny Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, Kevin Harlan, and our illustrious 2K Sports crew, this is Ernie Johnson. Have a good night, everybody.